What's up with your family? It's your boy, the one and only Brenda's baby, Remy L, my aunt. You are now tuned into my ITV. You already know the routine. I need y'all to like, share, subscribe, but most importantly, hit that notification bell and make sure it's on all so you can be alerted and notified whenever I drop this heat. So yesterday, I released a video of Hassan Campbell on Behind the Bar, and he was explaining, well, in my opinion, lying about, he was explaining the situation with, between that happened between him and Mcwifi'S, aka Gillz. He was explaining that situation, and he was explaining why he threatened to R-word his 12-year-old daughter and his 12-year-old son and every 12-year-old in his family. And I put that video out, and I explained that he didn't, it didn't go down the way that Hassan Campbell said it did. And what I should have did was line up the and play the actual video. So in this video, this is what you get. I want you guys to listen to him explain the story and why he did it and how he did it. And then I want you to watch the actual video of him doing it. And I want you to be the judge for yourself. And I'll give my commentary at the end. So without further ado, roll that beautiful bean footage.
Kevin Gillz, who is a nigger, who started off his YouTube career with me as my friend, like you niggas. He was the first nigga that showed me you don't have no friends on the internet. Kevin Gillz, I thought this nigga was my brother on the internet. I didn't realize that I was stupid because you ain't got no friends on the internet. He was the first nigga that showed me that you ain't got no friends. So what he did was, he act like he was fighting with me against Dan Botter. Then he started making fun of me being raped. That was the first time in the history of the internet that a nigga made fun of me being raped. I didn't know how to deal with that. So I said to him, what if I stuck heavy dick in your child? Your son or your daughter, would it be funny? Right? So when I said that to him, what he did was, he said, I'm going to take advantage of this. He sent the FBI to my house. I had to visit behind the FBI. I was crying when I made the video because I never had nobody making fun of me being raped. Now, years later, y'all made me fight on camera because y'all think it's funny that I got raped. I'm not talking finished. Mute the nigga while I'm talking. Behind the bar, mute this nigga while I'm talking. Shut the fuck up. I'm not done. You asked a question. I didn't ask you what you said. I asked you a question pertaining to something else. You didn't listen. So now I'm answering your question. You listen because you asked for it, so I'm giving it to you. Now my answer is, he made fun of me, so I threw that towards his kids to see how he fucking felt. And that same nigga apologized to me, and he's in my DM for the same shit that he did to me. Kevin Gillz, he started off on YouTube bigger than me. I surpassed him and everybody else. Niggas got a problem with that. I'm not here to talk about that. Now I answered that question. I don't give a fuck how you take it. Now back to what the fuck
that's
I said.
Some shit. That's
you cutting me off again.
You think this shit is righteous? You think
all right,
that
now
righteous?
You talking? You arguing?
You motherfucking right. I said I touched kids. When I fuck your 12-year-old son, 13-year-old son, you motherfucking right, I said I touch kids.
Let me find your motherfucking son. Right? Let me find your son or your daughter.
I said I touch kids.
And let me catch them at 12 years old. And when I stick heavy dick in that little 12, 13-year-old little bitch.
What part y'all missed? The people hurt me.
When I fucked your 12-year-old son, 13-year-old son, and then run through your family and fuck all the other children and your family.
I said I touched kids.
Let me find your motherfucking son. Right? Let me find your son or your daughter, and let me catch them at 12 years old.
And when I stick heavy dick in that little 12, 13-year-old little bitch, when I fuck your 12-year-old son, 13-year-old son, and then run through your family and fuck all the other children and your family. You dig? People understood that. He said he touched kids. I got some Vaseline. It ain't a problem, Kev. Now I'm here to touch kids in a different way.
As you can see, the nigga was lying. It was a totally different situation. The way he explained it is not the way it happened. It is not the way it happened. And I'm just not letting that slide. I don't really got too much commentary for this one because I said all I need to say in the last few videos about this situation. But what I will point out is two lies that I already pointed out. The FBI part, he said Kev Gillz sent the FBI to his house. That's not why the FBI was at his house. The FBI was at his house because he got caught with child pornography. Not once, but twice. That's why the FBI was at his house. So don't let that nigga lie and say, oh, this person sent the FBI to my house. No, that's not why the FBI was at your house. You got caught with child pornography. Twice. Not once, but twice. Secondly, he explained why he threatened to R-word Mcwifi'S kids as if it was a different way. He tried to add, would it be funny, into what he said, but that's not what he said, and that's not how he said it. He not one time did he say, would it be funny if I yada 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 your 12-year-old son or daughter and every 12-year-old in your family. And even if he did say that, there is no excuse for saying some shit like that. None. Everybody on the internet was making fun of you. So your excuse for why you did it don't make sense. Oh, I didn't know how to deal with it. Stop fucking lying, bro. Everybody who knew about it was making fun of you. So for you to say that doesn't make sense. And like I said, even if you said, would it be funny? You don't say no. You gotta be sick-minded for that to be your reaction. You gotta be a sick person or a person who is capable of doing something like that for that to be a reaction, for that to be something that you would say, something that would be the first thing that for that to be the first thing to come to mind to say to a person. You said because you he said because he wanted to hurt him, bruh, that's it. No matter how you slice it, It wasn't okay, and it is no excuse for that shit. Now, if he took some accountability and was like, there's no excuse for that, you know, and under no circumstances should I have said some shit like that, then that's different. You keep trying to lie and not apologize for it and stand on it. He's standing on what he said. So that's what makes it so fucked up and sick. So that's just my humble opinion on this little situation. Let me know how y'all feel about it in the comments section. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and definitely hit that notification bell. Make sure it's on all so you can be alerted and notified whenever I drop this heat. It's your boy, the one and only Brenda's baby, Remiel Ma'at. You were just tuned in to Ma'at TV. I see y'all when I see y'all. Until then, you better be careful there, little buddy.
Cocaine is a hell of a drug.
I do cocaine. Don't tell nobody.